Hey everybody, what's going on? Eric here, and if you made it this far, thanks for watching. Sorry you had to put up with my poor guitar playing, but figured I'd start getting into a little bit of something different and see what it would sound like mixed together. And, you know, really, I wouldn't call it playing, but, you know, it was okay. This was a little bit of a test, basically on the Dragonfire HEX-RED pickups to see how they're going to sound on a clean channel with a lot of effects added to it with no gate. Try to see if there was going to be any noise or any change in from one pickup selector to the other pickup selector when I flipped the switch on there, to see if there's going to be, you know, any buzzing or if these are going to be any noisy pickups or anything. Without the gate, it's pretty quiet, and I kind of figured with the effects that it would enhance some of the noise or noise that it would come from those pickups. You know, maybe if I didn't shield the cavity the way I did, or you know, these could be a pretty good pickup. They're quiet; they're not going to be very noisy at all without the shielding. I don't know, because I shielded it, didn't test them before I shielded them, but shielding helped out a lot. Possibly, maybe, I don't know. But again, this was just a little bit of a test, and it worked out pretty good. I gotta say, I've owned a lot of Ibanez GIO guitars in the past, and I bought and sold and fixed and sold or gave away or whatever, a lot of them. And they really haven't changed too much as far as neck profile, body shape. You may have a three-way selector switch instead of a five-way. I think some of the GIOs come with two humbuckers and a single coil, and or two humbuckers in general. And I kind of like the GIOs. They're pretty comfortable. They're not that heavy. They're kind of lightweight. And well, this is starting to sound like a review of the guitar, which actually this is a review of the pickups themselves. But I gotta say that these Dragonfires, I've been using them, buying them. I've bought several of the Crusaders. And they're like a high gain pickup, kind of like the one of the Seymour Duncans that's supposed to be like a high gain. They're wired pretty much the same way. And it seems like, you know, I really haven't had too many problems or any issues at all with installing the Dragonfires. I even compared the Dragonfire Actives, which are supposed to be like the EMG 8185s, I believe. And they're in my ESP guitar. And they seem to be somewhat in a league of their own. They're pretty damn close to an EMG, but not entirely for being active pickups. But they still sound good. And I kind of like these Dragonfires for an inexpensive pickup, an inexpensive guitar. Works out pretty good. And the bad thing is I didn't do a comparison as far as the stock pickups that came with the guitar. That was one thing that I should have done after I did a setup and everything else. But again, I replaced the strings on the guitar, and I would have had to, you know, remove the strings or you know, wedge them somehow in order to remove the pickguard and do all the work that I did to it, which would have been hard to do anyways, having to shield the cavity with the strings in a way. So that's kind of my bad. I should have did a comparison between the stock and the Dragonfires, but you can hear for yourself if some of you guys have one of these guitars that's got the Infinity pickups inside of it, I believe. And the nice thing about these hexes, and I think this is a reason why they call them the hexes, is because they're set up in a way that, like the Ibanez, oh man, I can't remember what those pickups are called again, but each one of the pole pieces is a set screw that you can adjust up or down and get more of a custom sound that you're looking for as far as, you know, what you're playing and how you're playing it. And not just one side of the pickup is adjustable, but both sides, both coils are adjustable on one humbucker to where you could change and have a custom thing. I kind of left it alone. They're pretty much all level with each other. I don't feel the need to have to adjust them. Reason being is because I'm really not too sure what I'm looking for as far as tone goes, and I really don't want to mess with something that I don't fully understand. You know, it's kind of like how you would see some of the pole pieces on a single coil, how they're kind of arched up in the middle following the arch of the strings, or sometimes they're straddled a little bit to where one is higher than the other. You know, those are set up professionally, and by all means, I am not a professional, sorry, as far as, you know, setting up pickups go. I can measure them and install them and, you know, set them up to where they're supposed to be as far as height from the strings, but that's about it. So anyways, thanks for watching, thanks for subbing, thanks for liking, thanks for not liking, and thanks for sharing or whatever you guys have been doing. And, you know, you guys take care, stay warm, and I'll see you next time.